Hello, everybody, and welcome to Vinyasa Flow Yoga. My name is Michelle Chua, and we're going to continue with our theme of hip and hamstring opening in this flow practice, as well as our theme of asmita and aparigraha. So if you might remember, we've been talking about the kleshas like in the past few weeks, and one of the root causes of suffering identified by the Yoga Sutras is ego-dominated sense of self. And we've also been talking about one practice from the first limb of yoga called aparigraha, which means non-attachment, ability to let life flow. So here is an excerpt from a book written by mindfulness teacher Pema Chodron called The Places That Scare You, A Guide to Fearlessness in Difficult Times. And she's talking about training to awaken our hearts and minds. And she mentions this word prajna paramita, prajna meaning unconditional wisdom, paramita means gone to the other shore. So she's going to reference that. Through paramita training, we learn to be comfortable with uncertainty, which is often the reason why it's difficult to let go, which is often why the ego wants to cling to beliefs, cling to a sense of normalcy, cling to whatever it is. Going to the other shore, which is paramita, has a groundless quality, a sense of being caught in the middle, being caught in an in-between state. We get into a raft on this shore where we're struggling with notions of right and wrong, busy solidifying the illusion of ground by constantly seeking predictability. And we're traveling across the river to the other side, where we are liberated from the narrow-mindedness and dualistic thinking that characterize ego clinging. So that's the traditional image. This is the picture I prefer, she says. In the middle of the river, with the shoreline out of view, imagine this, the raft begins to disintegrate. We find ourselves with absolutely nothing to hold on to. However, or from our conventional standpoint, this is scary and dangerous. However, one small shift of perspective will tell us that having nothing to hold on to is liberating. We could have faith that we won't drown. Holding on to nothing means we can relax with this fluid, dynamic world. So how do we practice that? That non-clinging? And here's just yet another angle to look at how to perceive that aparigraha and how to identify when the ego is taking over. And sometimes we don't even realize, you know, that need to categorize things as black or white, bad or good, right or wrong, is this polarization of the ego, created by the ego, when all things are a gradient within the spectrum. Right? We need both ends of it. We need the inhale and the exhale. We need the dark and the light. They all exist together. So how do we accept that and embrace aparigraha? All right, so let's bring it into our practice somehow of physical yoga. Sit in a way that you can turn out the thighs and go ahead and open them apart as widely as you can comfortably sit tall. You might like to elevate your pelvis on a block. Root down to the sitting bones, lift up, tall through the spine. Relaxing the shoulders down, and maybe close your eyes as you let your body be still, taking a moment to observe it. Feeling into your physical state of being. Tuning into the breath just as it is. Feeling into your energetic state of being. And tuning into your mind, your emotions, whatever's present. Feeling into your mental and emotional state of being. As you allow a deep breath in, join your palms to meet at your heart. Exhale through the mouth. What is one thing you can offer gratitude for as you begin this practice? Empowered by the energy of gratitude, begin to set your intention. What would you like to direct your focus towards? Strengthen and expand. And then setting the ego mind aside, choose someone or something to offer up your efforts to today, making a dedication of your practice to someone, a community, or a cause. And together, let's join our voices, chanting three ohms. Inhale deeply. Let's begin the practice of Ujjayi Pranayama. Closing the lips, softly narrow the back of your throat. Sustain your breath evenly in and out through the nose, creating a gentle whispering sound. Let's use this breathing technique and the sound that you're creating through it as a means to bring our perception to a sense of clarity in the now. Letting go of grasping and our energetic approach to our physical body, and inviting an open-minded, open body, open-heartedness. So keeping that breath going, let's meet in downward facing dog, taking a few breaths to move your body any way that it wants to move to start. You might pedal your feet gently in place. You might swivel your hips left and right. You might shake and nod your head a few times, relaxing the neck. Spread your fingers, open up space between them. Spread the shoulder blades apart, invite space across the upper back. Soften your neck. And lifting your hips high from down through the heels. And now let the body be still for three breaths in Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Inhale, raise your right leg behind you. And as you exhale, bend your right knee and rotate the thigh externally at the hip. Staying here, inhale, draw your left outer hip further back. And as you exhale, slowly hug the right knee high outside your right shoulder or upper arm and step the foot to the right side of your right pinky finger. Come onto your fingertips with hands on blocks or the floor. Lower your back knee, sinking the hips, and take a deep breath as you look up, coiling your chest up. Exhale, keep your feet where they are and begin to straighten both legs to what's comfortable for now, scissoring the right hip back, folding inside of the right shin. Inhale again, lower the back knee, kneeling lizard lunge, and coil your chest up. Exhale, straighten the legs, draw your heart forward in a wide pyramid pose. Inhale again, kneeling lizard lunge, lifting the chest. Exhale with a flat back fold in pyramid pose. Once more, inhale, kneeling lizard lunge. Exhale, wide pyramid pose. Step back to downward facing dog. Inhale, come forward into plank pose, stacking the shoulders over your wrists for about 3 to 5 breaths. Firm back to your inner heels, lift the sides of your waist, and lengthen your neck by gazing on the floor just ahead of your thumbs. Spin your triceps towards the back wall. Ashtangasana, which is a back bend. Exhale, lower your knees, then your chest and chin. Sticking your tailbone up, hug your elbows towards your ribs. Slide all the way to the floor for cobra. Press the tops of your feet down and roll the shoulders back and down, breathing in. Tuck your toes, firm in the belly and press up to plank. Then lift the hips back to downward facing dog. Full breath. Inhale, raise your left leg behind you. As you exhale, bend the knee and rotate the thigh open at the hip. Staying here, inhale, tack your right outer hip back. Exhale, hug the left knee high outside your left shoulder or upper arm and step the foot gently to the left side of your left hand. Lower your back knee and place your fingertips on blocks or the ground. Inhale, sink your hips and coil your chest up. Keep your feet where they are, and exhale, straighten your legs to what's comfortable and scissor the left hip back as you fold inside of your left leg. Inhale, lower the back knee again and coil your chest up. Exhale, straighten the legs and bow as if you have a flat back. Couple more times, inhale, kneeling lizard lunge while lifting the chest. Exhale, wide pyramid pose. Inhale, kneeling lizard lunge. Exhale, wide pyramid pose. Step back to plank pose. Again, let's pause. Firm back to your inner heels and activate your quadriceps, the front muscles of your thighs. Lengthen your chest and crown forward and lift your lower belly. Lift the space between the shoulder blades and rotate your triceps towards the back wall. Take another deep breath, but this time exhale as you glide way forward before bending the elbows. Hug the elbows towards your side ribs, lowering halfway in Chaturanga Dandasana. Then come all the way down. Firm down to the tops of your feet again and inhale, broaden your chest up to Cobra, Bhujangasana. Tuck your toes, firm in the belly, and exhale, press up to plank, then downward facing dog. Imagine you're walking on a tightrope and that you don't have knee joints, so your legs stay straight like pencils. Keep your hands where they are and plug your right thigh bone up into the hip socket, stepping the right foot forward of the left down the midline of the mat. And then plug the left thigh bone up, step the left foot in front of the right toes and keep going, walking on your imaginary tightrope to the top of your mat into Uttanasana, standing forward fold. Press into blocks or the floor. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, lengthen your spine forward. Exhale, fold. Press to your feet. Inhale, sweep your arms forward and rise into a standing back bend, rolling the shoulders down as you lift the heart. Exhale, Padasana, join your hands at your heart. Bring back your intention and let's flow through sun salutations. Inhale the arms forward, coil your chest up in Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, bow from your hips into Uttanasana. Press down with your fingertips. Inhale, lengthen your spine forward, Ardha Uttanasana. Step back to plank, glide forward as you exhale, hug the elbows to your ribs in Chaturanga Dandasana. Lower all the way again, or here, flip the toes and coil the chest up to upward facing dog. Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, we'll meet in downward facing dog, pausing there for 3 deep breaths. When you finish your third exhale, walk or lightly jump to the front of your mat. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Rooting down, inhale, rise, arms forward. Roll the shoulders back and down in Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, hands together at the heart. Let's keep this going for 2 more rounds. Inhale, Urdhva Hastasana with a back bend. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Step back and glide forward or float into Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Cobra or Upward Dog. Exhale to Downward Dog. Be still for 3 breaths there. Steadying your gaze. When you finish your third exhale, walk or lightly jump to the front of your mat. Then inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, arms forward, Urdhva Hastasana with a back bend. Exhale, hands together at the heart once more. Inhale, Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Step or float to Chaturanga. Continue with your vinyasa. When you arrive at Downward Dog, hold still for 3 breaths. And listen to your breathing. Spacing it out. When you finish the third, walk or lightly jump to the top. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, Padasana at the heart. Moving on to our last series of sun salutations, bring your feet together to touch, preparing for chair pose. Join your hands at your heart. Let's go right into the flow of it for 2 rounds. Slow down the breath. Inhale, bend your knees to touch. Sit low in Utkatasana, chair pose. Exhale, shift forward and fold. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Step or float back. Continue into your vinyasa. When you arrive at Downward Dog, inhale, raise your right leg behind you. Exhale, step the foot softly beside your right thumb. Spin the back heel down. Facing forward, inhale, rise up to Warrior One. Ride the exhale down into your vinyasa. Downward Dog. Inhale, raise your left leg. Exhale the foot softly beside your left thumb. Drop the right heel. Facing forward, inhale, Warrior One. Exhale, lower, vinyasa. Downward Dog. Pause again. Recalibrate. 3 breaths. After emptying the third breath, walk or lightly jump to the front of your mat. With feet touching, inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, Utkatasana, chair. Exhale, Padasana. Last round, same sequence. Inhale, Utkatasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Step or float back, insert your vinyasa. Taking your time to move to your breath from downward dog. Inhale, raise the right leg. Exhale, the foot forward and drop the back heel. Inhale, rise up, Virabhadrasana one. Exhale, lower to your vinyasa. Downward dog, inhale, raise your left leg. Exhale, the foot beside your left thumb, right heel down. Inhale, rise, Virabhadrasana one. Exhale, lower into your vinyasa. Pause again in downward facing dog for three deep breaths. Feel into the energy of your body and mind, inviting a sense of fluidity, flow. When you finish the third exhale, walk or float to the front. Then inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, Utkatasana, chair. Exhale, rise up, Padasana. Let's turn to face the wide width of the mat here. Take your blocks with you. Step your feet wide apart, parallel to each other, and place the blocks behind your calves. Let's start with your right leg. So I'm not mirroring you here, so just pay attention to your own right leg from the right hip socket. Turn out the right leg 90 degrees towards the short edge of your mat. And then turn the left leg in about 45 degrees. Align your right heel to intersect the arch of your left foot. Let's prepare for triangle pose. Open the arms wide, chest is facing the wide width of the mat. Glide your hips back past the left heel, reach the right hand forward past the right knee, and then place the right hand on the right side of your right shin on a block of the floor. Adjusting the height of that hand so that you can lengthen the right side of your torso as you raise the left arm. Stack your two shoulders and wrists. Lengthen your neck by pressing the shoulder blades down your back and spin your chest slightly to face the sky. Then direct your gaze onto one point. If it feels okay on your neck, try looking up past the left thumb. Stay here another five deep breaths in Trikonasana. Press down to your feet, inhale, rise up, and let's parallel the feet to start. This time, rotate your left leg out 90 degrees from the hip. Rotate your right leg in 45 degrees. Align your left heel to intersect the arch of your right foot. Open your arms wide, glide your hips towards the right heel and reach the left hand past the left knee, placing your left hand on the left side of your left shin, maybe on a block. Right up against the leg. Press your left hip crease back towards your outer right foot as you stretch the top of your head forward past the left foot. Stack your shoulders and wrists in one line as you send the shoulder blades down your back and spin your chest slightly towards the sky. Direct your gaze, your drishti on one spot, maybe up past the right thumb. And let's stay another five deep breaths here in Trikonasana. Press down to both of your feet. Inhale, rise all the way up, parallel your feet, and let's prepare for a wide-legged forward fold with the hands clasped behind your back. Inhale, roll your shoulders back and down. Exhale, hinge from your hips and tilt your weight as far forward as you can balance. Drop your head completely
while stretching the arms forward away from your lower back to open up across the shoulders. Bend your elbows slightly here to lift the shoulder bones up away from the neck. Let your head be heavy. This is a variation of Prasarita Parottanasana, wide-legged forward fold. Let's give it another 3 full breaths. So if you haven't noticed, got this wide-legged theme in our physical practice today, besides the hip openers. Lower your hands, grab the blocks, you might need them, and take them with you as you come up halfway, lifting the chest forward. Turn out your right leg at the hip again, turn out the left leg as well, and bend your right knee coming into Skandasana, which is like a half squat. Curl up your left toes and flex the left foot. Now you can stay high up with the hips way far from the ground, or you can sink down, just depending on what your body's saying is okay. If you are completely down, you have the option of crossing the right arm in front of the right thigh and raising the left arm up, or wrapping, maybe wrapping both arms, holding the left wrist, clasping the hands. Just find what's available without strain, where you can feel the body breathe continuously in balance, still. Steadying your gaze up towards the sky. A couple more breaths. Release the arms if they're bound. Grab your blocks again. Let's come through center with both legs still turned out. Bend the knees. You're in a wide-legged squat. Transfer your weight towards your left foot as you bend the left knee. Make sure the knee is in line with the middle toe. And curl your right toes up, sinking your pelvis to whatever degree is available. So flex the right foot, especially if your pelvis is high off the ground. That flex foot will help you maintain your balance. If you're sitting on the ground, you can cross the left arm in front of the left thigh, raise the right arm up, maybe wrap. So here's a variation of Skandasana. Give it another 3 deep breaths. Release your arms, take hold of the blocks again. One more time through center in a wide-legged squat. And from your wide-legged squat, parallel your feet. Come back to your forward fold, a few more breaths. This time lower the hands on the floor or on blocks. Optional to take a moment and tripod headstand if you practice that. Placing the hands back behind the feet so that you create a triangular base out of your palms and the crown of your head. And if you are practicing tripod headstand, you might take the legs into a straddle, continuing with our hip opening, wide-legged theme. Few last breaths. Your feet are off the floor, set them down, parallel to each other again. Inhale, crawl your hands forward, lengthen the spine, parallel to the ground. Bend your knees generously. Exhale the hands to the hips, point the elbows towards the sky. Inhale, lead with your chest to rise. Let's bring the blocks to the top of your mat. Step your feet together. Preparing for hand to big toe pose. So you may want to use a strap for this one, in which you step the ball of your right foot into the strap, holding onto the strap. If you're gonna clasp your big toe, you have the option of starting in a forward fold, clasping the big toe with the right piece fingers, and then from the forward fold, lift the right foot forward. If you're taking the strap, bend the right knee in front of you as you stand on your left foot. Hold the strap in your right hand as close to the right foot as you can. Either way, flex the foot, kick it away as you pull it. So play a little tug of war, as that will help you to create a sense of balance.
roll the right hip down, extend the right leg forward, and rotate the thigh externally. So whether you're holding the strap or clasping the big toe. Then begin to open the right leg out to the right side, open the left arm out to the left side. Maybe look over the left shoulder. A few more breaths in Uttita Hasta Parangushtasana. If you're looking away, look forward, bring the right leg in front, raise your left arm up, stand tall for one more breath. Exhale the right foot down. Maybe roll out the left ankle or give the left foot a shake. And let's prepare for side two. See if you can come into it the same way as you did the first side. So whether you're looping your foot in the strap and bending the knee in front of you, or you're starting in a standing forward fold, clasping the left big toe and then bring the leg in front. Come into standing on your right foot, extend the left leg forward, kick it away as you pull it, roll your left sitting bone down towards your inner right heel, and then turn your left thigh bone externally at the hip before you open the left leg to the left and the right arm to the right. If your spine starts to tilt off center, adjust your arm and leg that are lifted so that your spine stays vertical, your shoulders stay stacked above your hips. If your balance feels pretty stable, you might be gazing past your right thumb for the last few breaths and to big toe pose. If you're gazing away, look forward, bring your left leg in front, raise your right arm, stand tall for one more breath. And then exhale, step it down. Maybe give your right ankle some circles or shake out the right foot for a moment. And let's come to the top of the mat. Bring your feet together. Inhale, sweep your arms forward, roll your shoulders back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees, chair pose. Stay low in the hips and lift your heels, chair pose. Sink the hips lower and lower, keep the heels high. Draw the navel in and up. Splay your knees apart and either walk your hands forward to bow or walk your hands a foot away from your feet for crow pose, Bakasana or Kakasana. If you're going into the arm balance, hollow your belly, lift your hips, bend your elbows back like Chaturanga, keep the arms parallel. Hug your knees as high as you can outside your shoulders or upper arms and gaze on the ground ahead to lean your weight forward. If you're lifting your feet, bring them together to touch. Maybe straighten the arms and that will take you to crane pose. You could float your legs back to Chaturanga, step back to downward dog on your own, or take a few rounds of cat-cow. Let's meet in downward facing dog when you're ready. Downward dog, inhale, raise your right leg behind you. Exhale, bend the knee, rotate the thigh externally at the hip. Inhale, tack the left hip back. Exhale, hug the right knee high outside the right shoulder and stay there or bend the elbows back and lean the chest forward. Coming into another arm balance, maybe straightening the right leg, maybe lifting the left foot and step the right foot to the right side of your right hand and lower your back knee. Now let's stay still in lizard lunge. Flexing your right foot to stabilize your right knee. Splay open your right thigh to lean the outer foot on the floor while gently scissoring your right hip back. You might place your hands on block. You might lower to your forearms. You might bend the left knee and scoot it back so that you might backstroke the right arm and catch hold of your left foot bring it gently towards your glute to stretch into your left quadricep, hip flexors, and to roll the right shoulder open. Stay another 5 slow breaths here. Gently release the back leg if you have it. Step your right foot to the right side, the left side of your right thumb. So you have a regular size lunge rather than a lizard lunge. And with your left hip stacked above your left knee, place your hands on blocks of the floor, framing your right leg for half split, Ardha Hanumanasana, with the option to move into full split, Hanumanasana. So flex your right foot, lift the ball of the foot, and plug the right thigh bone back into the hip socket to straighten the right leg. Extend your chest forward and hug your front ribs in, relaxing your shoulders back as you fold. Stay here or tuck the left toes and begin to slide your right heel forward towards a full split. Keeping your right hip drawing back, your left hip coming forward, so as to square your hips to face the front like you would in Warrior One or crescent lunge. You could also use one of your blocks to support underneath your right hamstring, and then use your hands to help square the hips. If you're sitting on the ground, you could raise your arms and interlace the fingers, pointing the index fingers up. Or fold over your right shin. Let's take another 5 deep breaths where you are. Keep flexing your right foot, engaging the right quadricep, supporting your right hamstring without locking the knee. Take your time as we transition back to downward facing dog. Place your hands on blocks or the floor. Steady the breath as you slowly drag the right foot back. Lifting your hips, downward facing dog. Allow a few breaths to notice how your body feels. How are you bringing the practice of non-attachment, non-gripping, non-clinging, and observing the ego mind? Inhale, raise your left leg behind you. Exhale, bend the left knee. Rotate the thigh open at the hip. Inhale, tack the right hip back. Exhale, hug the left knee high outside the left shoulder. Stay here or lean forward and bend the elbows back. Coming into arm balance, straightening the legs perhaps. Maybe lifting the right foot too. Then step the left foot to the left side of your left hand and lower the right knee for lizard lunge. Flex your left foot as you splay open your left thigh, leaning on the outer edge of your left foot. Place your hands on blocks or the ground or come down onto your elbows. If it's available for you, you can lie the right knee back and bend it. Backstroke the left arm and catch hold of the right foot, gently bringing it towards your glutes as you roll open the left shoulder. Whatever variation you're in, let's be still. Direct the breath. 5 more cycles. Gently release your back foot if you're holding it, and let's narrow our stance to hips distance apart in your kneeling lunge. Stack your right hip above your right knee,
Maybe place your hands in blocks and let's prepare for Ardha or full Hanumanasana. Lift the ball of your left foot flexed and plug the thigh bone back into the hip socket while extending your chest forward, folding towards your left inner shin. If you're moving towards full Hanumanasana, tuck your right toes and keep your hips squared forward as you begin to slide the left heel forward, breath by breath, scissoring the left hip back, rotating the right hip forward, maybe using a block under the left hamstring, and placing your hands in your hips to guide the hips squared. If your pelvis meets the ground, you might raise the arms overhead, interlacing the fingers except your index, or bowing towards your left shin, flexing your left foot and quadricep. Five more breaths at least. Be gentle as you start to exit the pose. Place your hands on blocks or the floor. Slide your left heel back, returning to one more downward facing dog, pausing there for a few breaths to observe. Observe the kinds of thoughts streaming through your mind. And the energy you feel. And inhale, glide forward into plank. And exhale through chaturanga all the way to the ground. Let's lower the right ear onto the floor, whether on a block or straight on the ground, and slide your right arm open out to the right, palm face down. Place your left hand on the earth beside your left shoulder to press the ground away as you slowly roll over onto your right hip. Slide your right shoulder blade down your back ribs and then lean as far back as it's helpful for you to open up the inner right shoulder without strain. You might step the left foot behind you. You might wrap the left arm behind you. Stay another five deep breaths here. Gently roll onto your stomach. Lower your left ear to the ground or onto a block and slide the left arm out to the left, palm face down. With your right hand beside your right shoulder on the earth, press the ground away and gently roll over to your left side. Slide the left shoulder blade down your back ribs. And see how far your left shoulder wants you to lean back. You might step the right foot behind you. You might wrap the right arm behind you. Again, let's give it another five full breaths. Slowly roll onto your stomach and please press back into child's pose for a few breaths, sinking your hips down to your feet as your feet come together, knees together or apart, arms wherever you wish. Gently roll your spine upright to sit. Let's extend the left leg in front of you for a seated twist. Step the right foot on the ground, either in front of your right hip or outside your left knee. If the latter, you might choose to bend the left knee. Round your two sitting bones, place the right hand behind your pelvis, raise the left arm and inhale, sit up tall. Exhale, twist to your right and hold on to your right leg with your left arm or hook the elbow outside of the thigh. Five more breaths. exhale as you unwind. And let's hug the thighs closer together for Gomukhasana. Separating the feet with knees both bent, or straighten the bottom leg and flex the bottom foot. Raise your left arm up, rotate the tricep forward and bring the elbow behind the head. Reach your right hand underneath behind you. Either you're dangling a strap from the left hand to hold with both hands, or clasping the hands. Press down through your hips, lift up to your chest, breathe in. Exhale, extend your heart forward as you're bowing. Gomukhasana, cow face pose. Press down to your sitting bones again and inhale, lift your chest to rise. Release your arms and legs. And let's set up for the twist. Same way if you can as you did the first side. Step the left foot in front of the hip or outside the right knee. Maybe bend the right knee. Place your left hand behind your pelvis. Raise your right arm up. Sit up tall as you breathe in. Twist to the left as you breathe out and lower your right arm. Maybe hook the elbow outside the thigh. 5 breaths. Exhaling, unwind your spine and hug your thighs closer together, either keeping both knees bent and the feet splay out, or straightening the bottom leg forward and flexing that foot. Gomukhasana, raise your right arm up, rotate the tricep forward, bring the elbow behind your head, and reach the left hand underneath so the hands can clasp, or dangle a strap from the right hand and hold on to the strap. Press down to your sitting bones and lengthen the spine up as you breathe in. Extend the heart forward as you hinge from the hips, breathing out. Root down to your sitting bones. Inhale, slowly rise. Release the arms, release the legs straight, and extend the legs in front of you. Preparing for Paschimottanasana, seated forward fold. Root down to your sitting bones. You might opt to use a strap around the balls of your feet, or walk the hands down your legs and maybe clasp your big toes with your peace fingers. Flex your feet and press the insteps forward. Root down through your sitting bones and lengthen front and back of the spine, rolling the shoulders down. Keep a slight lift in the chest, a little bit of cobra as you're bowing. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, bow a little bit. Inhale, root the pelvis and lengthen the spine some more. Exhale, bow another little bit. And keep going, a few more breaths. Your pelvis with your heart, lifting the chest first, breathe in to rise. Okay, let's set up for a restorative heart opening supported fish pose with legs straight out or feet on the ground wider than hips distance, knees knocked in together, which can help open the lower back horizontally sideways, or Supta Baddha Konasana, continuing the hip opening. We drop the knees apart and bring the soles of your feet together. So grab your 2 blocks. Here are some options. High block for under the skull, all the way at the rear of the mat. Medium height block, crossing the mat, space them apart so that the medium height block is where you land the area that's right under the bottom tips of your shoulders. And the back of your head is on the tallest block. If you're feeling pretty open in the shoulders at the front, the chest, you might make an equal sign out of the 2 blocks, same 2 blocks parallel to each other. So set up your legs as you wish. And as you're leaning back, make sure you have open space at the neck. Adjust the blocks even a slight adjustment can make such a huge difference. You want to be able to roll the shoulders back and down into the space between the blocks, encouraging wide open chest, wide open heart center, open for breath too. Rotate the triceps down to flip the palms face up, landing the backs of the hands just outside of the legs. Feel a sense of symmetry in the hips, the feet, the legs, and the shoulders. Close your eyes. And let's take a cooling, relaxing breathing technique of inhaling for 5 counts, expanding the belly as you breathe in, and exhaling through the lips for 7 counts, softening the belly down as you breathe out. So abdominal breath and longer exhales, and exhaling through the mouth. Let's try a few rounds together. Empty this breath. Then inhale 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, inhale 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, inhale 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep going a couple more rounds on your own before you let go of controlling the breath. And when you're ready, with an exhalation, let the breath go, let it flow naturally. Continue to feel it, sense it, be present with it. You might choose to remain in this position as we now enter corpse pose or shavasana. Or if you're going to transition out of it, do so very gently. You might turn over to one side and remove any props you don't want to use, and then position your body in what relaxed pose you want to be still in. We'll be in Shavasana for a few minutes before our 5 minutes of meditation.
your body rest here in stillness a little longer. With your eyes closed, observe how your physical body feels now. Tuning into your body, ask it how it wants to begin moving. And then let it take its time, being gentle, easing out of stillness. Eventually, turn over to your right side and rest your head on your arm, pausing there. Allow a few breaths to pass. Feel the sensations of the breath, just letting it flow naturally. How do you feel energetically right now? As you press your hands into the ground, begin to lift your body slowly. Place it in a comfortable position to sit for your meditation practice. Feel what you're sitting on evenly through the left and right sides of your pelvis. Allow your spine to lift tall, creating space for the natural breath, lifting the heart with a sense of open-heartedness. Relax the body. You might stack your palms face up on your lap in front of you. You might bring the thumb, first fingers to touch, palms face down. Notice what resonates with you at this moment. Choose to either close your eyes or steady a soft gaze on one spot at eye level. And let's begin our meditation practice. Start by resting your awareness on the sensations of the natural breath, just letting it flow freely, landing your mind's eye, the point in your body where you can most feel the breath. Natural exhalation. Allow your whole being to rest deeper and deeper into stillness and open awareness. Allow whatever comes up to your awareness to just come up as it is. Whether it be a sound, physical feeling, a thought, an emotion. But as you rest deeply in stillness, just allow whatever it is to come and to go on its own. Simply notice what comes into your awareness without having to grasp for it or push it away.
find yourself grasping or resisting, it's okay. Remember that you're human. Quickly forgive yourself, and there's your window of opportunity. Come back to that restful stillness of open awareness. Like you are the sky, the vast open sky. And everything that comes and goes, simply the weather changing. How does it feel to take that seat of acceptance of what is? How does it feel to give yourself permission to not react, but simply to hold space? I invite you to experiment with doing so at other times throughout your day or tomorrow. And again, observe how that feels. Just pausing, observing it all. Giving yourself the freedom to be with uncertainty. The palms to meet at the heart as you recall something to be grateful for now, something that you feel grateful for. Thank yourself for showing up and following through with your practice today. And now recall your intention that you set for it. Remember the being or beings or cause that you dedicated it to. Picture them receiving benefit from your practice. And let's close together chanting three ohms. Inhale deeply. Bow in towards the light within. The light in me bows to the light in you. Namaste. Thank you.